Welcome students, myself Ashwini Sharma, and let's start our today's topic, that is chromosomes. Chromosomes are literally mean student colored body, and this term is coined by Waldier. Next student, they are thick rod like structures which are formed by thickening or condensation of chromatin threads. Chromatin threads are the structure which are observed before cell division. When cell division starts, then these start to get thick and turn into chromosomes. So now, if we see the structure of mature chromosome student, it has two identical halves. It's the one half and this is the second half. And these two halves are called chromatids. Mature chromosome has one pair of chromatids. Before turning into a mature chromosome student, it has single chromatid. When it gets mature, then these chromatids undergo duplication and result in formation of a pair of chromatids. So, if we see the structure of single chromatid student, in this case, it has one constriction in the center that is called primary constriction. This primary constriction is also called centromere. We can generally say that center of the chromatid is called centromere. Besides this student, in some chromosomes, there may be another constriction that is called secondary constriction. Generally, primary constriction is there in chromosome, but in some case there may be secondary constriction. And the structure beyond secondary constriction, if secondary constriction is there, then this is called satellite, and such chromosome then we will call sat chromosomes. What we will call sat chromosome. So if satellite is there, then that chromosomes are called sat chromosome, and in sat chromosome only you will find the secondary constrictions. In this secondary constriction students, sometimes there are genes which are responsible for the formation of nucleus, and if genes are present in this secondary constriction student which are responsible for formation of nucleus, then this region is called NOR, that is nuclear organizer. What is called? That is NOR, nuclear organizer. Okay, when secondary constriction have some genes for the formation of nucleus. So what is the function of NOR, that is nuclear organizer? It has genes which are responsible for synthesis of nucleus. Beside this student, inside the chromatids, there is highly coiled chromatin material, that is DNA. This is basically a chromatin material, that is DNA. It is highly coiled. Now, if we see the outer membrane of the chromatid student, it is called pellicle. Inside pellicle, the material, that is space, that is called matrix, and these coiled structures are called chromonemata. Chromonemata. This can also be called chromonema. And next student, at the end of the chromosome, each chromosome, this boundary, this line, this is called telomere. Because I have drawn the diagram of sat chromosome, so on this side, satellite part is there, but in general chromosome, it has at the end the part that is called at the tip, that is called telomere. And what is the function of telomere? It prevents the fusion of this chromosome with the other chromosome. So it fixes one boundary. So it avoid the fusion of particular chromosome with the other chromosomes. So students, tip of chromosome is called telomere, which prevent the fusion of the particular chromosome with adjacent chromosome. Next student, one more thing that you have to note, at primary constriction there are disc-shaped structure. These disc-shaped structures are called kinetochore, and these are the structures with which the spindle fiber attached at the time of cell division. And you will discuss cell division, then you will be more aware about these terms, that how they work. So what is the function of kinetochore? With this kinetochore, spindle fiber get attached at the time of cell division. So this is all about student, about the structure of chromosome. Now next student, we have to discuss about the types of chromosomes, and the classification of our chromosome is based on the location of this primary constriction. The primary constriction position can be varies. On the behalf of that primary constriction, the chromosome can be classified into many types. So next topic is classification of chromosomes on the basis of this primary constriction. Now students, let's talk about the types of the chromosomes and what is the criteria of types of chromosome that on the basis of position of centromere. So there are four types of chromosome student on the basis of position of centromere. First is metacentric chromosome, second submetacentric chromosome, third egocentric chromosome, and fourth telocentric chromosome. So students, if centromere is present exactly at the center, then such chromosomes are called metacentric chromosome, and in such chromosomes both the arms of the chromatids are equal. So what are metacentric chromosome? When centromere is at the center. And student, when centromere is slightly away from the middle, then such chromosomes are called submetacentric chromosome. Agar chromosome mein centromere center se thoda upar hai, in that case it is not exactly in the center, then that chromosomes are called submetacentric chromosomes. Okay students, whereas in case of metacentric, the centromere is exactly at the center. So in both cases, almost both the arms are almost equal. In this case, equal. In this case, they appear to be equal because the centromere is not exactly in the center. In case of acrocentric chromosome students, the centromere is quite far away from the center position. So such type of chromosomes are called acrocentric chromosome. And in this case, students, the length of the arms on both sides is unequal because centromere is very far away from the center. So in metacentric, exactly at the center. In case of submetacentric, they are slightly away from the center, whereas in this case acrocentric, they are quite far away from the center. Lastly student, telocentric chromosome, in which centromere is present exactly at one end of the chromosome, and in this case the arms are present only at one end. So when centromere is present exactly at the one end and when arms are present only one side, then such chromosomes are called telocentric chromosome. So on the basis of position of centromere student, there are four type of chromosome: metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric, and telocentric. So this is all about student for the discussion of chromosome. In this way student, we have completed our this chapter, that is cell, the unit of life. In the next class we will start a new chapter. Till then, take care. Thanks.